and talk. Now live in studio, your host, local and national real estate expert and consumer advocate, Ron Siegel.
And hello again. Welcome to Ron Siegel Radio. This is the show with no real boundaries as we discuss current events, financial markets, politics, sports, even poking fun at the rest of the media. This is the show that connects the dots of confusion delivered by conflicting media reports. We connect the dots so you know the actions you can take, how your family or business can benefit from current events. Most of all, thank you for joining me. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That is my message, and I will be delivering it every day. We're very focused, Joe. We only chat about items that affect the roof over your head, your bank account, and anything I feel would benefit you. But before we get to our intriguing content today, please join me in welcoming our featured guest and repeat offender. Lucas Smith is in the house. Welcome.
Hey, thanks, Ron. I appreciate it. You know, this is the only time I've been called a repeat offender that it was a good thing.
Absolutely. And I remind you, if you ever have any more finance-related questions, I am the consumer advocate looking out for you. And you can reach out to me directly, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Just remember, that's the number you call anytime for assistance. When you call that number, it comes directly to me first. There are no operators standing by. I am it.
Quiet, numbskulls. I'm broadcasting.
While I do have a great team when it comes to developing a financing plan, a plan to save you money, I personally work with you. Even if you don't have any needs today, save this number on your phone for future reference, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. Yes, of course, we are celebrating today. Now, today is not a politically correct celebration day. And don't shoot the messenger. I'm just looking at what they've got on the screen here. It says National Housewives Day. And that's something, and I'm not politically correct, so I am very appreciative of my wife every day. National Housewives Day. I don't know if they have a National House Husbands Day. I don't know, but that would just be...
I got a bad feeling about this.
Yeah, something I better be careful because I might get in trouble. There's also National Sandwich Day. Have you eaten anorexia? Yes, I do do indulge in sandwiches many, many times. Let's take a look at what else is going on in the world today that's probably more important than those things. Is there anything going on today? I just wonder. In the Dow Jones Industrial Average, it is up 562 points. S&P 500 up 62. NASDAQ up almost 200. Oil's up 99 cents a barrel. I'm not going to talk to you about gasoline because Calizuela, I think, is now number one most expensive in the country, but that's a different story. U.S. 10-year Treasury up to 0.89. Who would ever thought we'd say up to 0.89, up about 0.3. When you look at that, if you're on fixed income, that is a tough one to stomach. Let's take a look. What else is going on? There's a lot. Did you see this one? I know. I get a lot of love letters. an interesting commentary that hit. I missed this. I must admit, my son had to call and tell me this one yesterday. So, court declares Governor Newsom's abuse of power unconstitutional. Yeah, that's we're glad to see that. Governor Newsom thinks that he is King Newsom, but thank goodness we've got a couple of assemblymen, Kevin Kiley and James Gallagher, who sued the governor. Yeah, this isn't a one-man rule, Governor. You've got to do something a little more than that. And now we've got five different mayors in Southern California have all signed a letter pushing Governor Newsom to reopen major theme parks soon. Fascinating here. You don't see this get together very often. Anaheim, obviously a Republican mayor. Los Angeles, obviously not a Republican. Riverside, Santa Ana, San Jose, Bakersfield, Fresno, San Diego, all pushing the governor to reconsider allowing larger theme parks to reopen sooner than state guidelines. Where's the lawsuit on that one? We need that one to get these guys opened and get the governor. You know, Governor King, I guess maybe he thinks he's a king. Of course, he is related to Nancy Pelosi, so you got to wonder there. A lot of folks are worried because apparently the D-Day is coming on Saturday. think that's when a lot more people from Disney are doing to probably tens of thousands, they say. Plans to lay off 28,000 people across its theme parks.
But we have to pass the bill so that you can find out what is in it.
Yeah, so not fun. There's a lot of business owners in the Disneyland district and the resort district in Anaheim. I'm sure the same with the SeaWorld area, Magic Mountain, Universal Studios. All feeling the pain from this governor. Do you think it's helping? Right? I mean, we wore masks all this time, and we've got a spike in coronavirus cases. We stayed home. I just saw a new one in Massachusetts. You got to love this one. Massachusetts, no more than 10 people in your house. Now, I don't know about you, but there's no way in the world that I'm number one, the police are not coming in to check, right? They've got to have a search warrant for that. So ain't going to happen in my household. I'll tell you that. We are having a normal Thanksgiving, as normal as it can be. Let's take a look at what else is going on. Yeah, there's a little election today. So we're watching that one as well. There's some great information. I don't want to cause any problems here. Well, maybe I do. But have you seen what some of the people that actually get elections correct? Have you seen what they have to say? Not the ABC poll that oversamples the Democrat. But take a look at this one. There was only two polls that got the elections correct last year. One of them was the Trafalgar Group, right? And I'm looking at their screen right now. North Carolina, they've got President Trump leading by about 2 points. Arizona, they've got President Trump leading that one by about 3 points. They've got Nevada going to Vice President Biden by about 2 points. They've got Florida going to the president. That one there, he's got a 3-point lead there. We've got Michigan. Yeah, they don't want to release their stats because President Trump is leading that one by 3 points. Minnesota, the vice president is leading. So take a look at some of these. That's the Trafalgar Group. They're actually the one that got it correct last year. Then we've got the indicator from, if you're a market person, if you watch the stock market at all, you've got the stock market indicator. So that one's predicted the 87% accuracy since I think it's 1928, something along those lines. If the incumbent part, if the stock market is up for the 90 days leading up to the election, the incumbent party wins. If the stock market, as measured by the S&P 500, is down during the 90 days leading up to the election, the challenging party wins. Where are we as of right now? It's pretty close. Last week was a very, very tough week for the S&P 500, but yeah, we've got a drum roll going. I'm trying to find the exact number here because I did have it on my screen a little earlier. Yeah, we're still looking up. So this particular survey, yeah, it was 32.94 on August 3rd. The S&P 500 closed at 33.10 yesterday. And I think I've already looked at that for you once this morning, but I'll look at it again just to make sure that we are still on track because, yes, the S&P 500 is now up 65 points right now as we speak. So this is another one. This is just one of those other things that says the president should be reelected. I'm going to tell you right here, right? Actually, I told you yesterday anyway. So if you just look at what's going on, I was watching. Now, traditionally, the candidates don't go out and campaign on the election day. Well, I think that the vice president might be a little nervous because he did come out of the bunker and was doing a campaign stop this morning. And both people that were there watching him did applaud, I think. Both of them were very excited to see the vice president. I don't think that one was Hunter. Didn't look like it was Hunter to me, but it might have been. But there was no excitement there. Now, take a look at the difference between what the president had yesterday. Did you see any of those rallies yesterday that the president was at? I'm sorry, peaceful protests that the president was at yesterday? Tens of thousands of people. Now, I go back a long time in watching elections. I don't think I've ever seen a time when there was tens of thousands of people showing up to any campaign. Right? I mean, this is just amazing. And I've never ever, and I watched a little bit of the one last night, of two of the rallies last night. People chanting to a politician, we love you. Now, has anybody ever said that to Joe Biden? I don't think his son even says that to Joe Biden, right? I mean, that just doesn't happen. But the people chanting that, I mean, I've heard four more years. I've heard chants of USA. In this election, I did hear 12 more years. That was a different part of it, though. But the issue came up, I mean, chanting that to a president, to a politician, I think there's a love fest going on here. And I did see somebody even predicted. Now, I'm not going to put my friend Lucas on the spot here, but and we were talking about this before the broadcast. I saw somebody actually predicting that the state of New York might go red. Now, you probably can't get out of New York City to go vote because it's all boarded up and it's a ghost town. But, you know, can you imagine if New York goes red? It would be pretty amazing if that happened, but I don't know. We'll see where it goes. You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. When we come back, I've got something very, very new and different to chat with you about today. I haven't done this one with you. Strategy beats rate always. You know, you've heard me say that many, many times, but could you imagine having a home buying strategy that can save you maybe $30,000 or $40,000 in interest expense? Yeah, I'm going to show that to you today. You can reach me anytime. Our off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio. On Twitter, @ronsiegel. If you missed any part of our broadcast, shame on you. But the replay is available. Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Ron Siegel, the number 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
So, I'm free, and I won't forget the men who died.
Real Estate Radio is hosted by local real estate and finance expert Ron Siegel. The purpose of this show is to help consumers understand what's really going on in our local real estate market. We're teaching you the why and the how to, so you'll always be one step ahead of everyone else. Whether you need to sell your home for top dollar, refinance and save money, or even buy a bargain in Southern California, Ron Siegel can help. Call Ron directly at 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Take advantage of speaking with Ron anytime you're entering a real estate transaction. Having someone who can answer all of your questions that truly cares about you and your family's best interest is priceless. Call Ron Siegel today and you'll be glad you did. 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or you can visit Real Estate Radio with Ron .com for more info.
Blue Water Credit Repair is the industry leader in fixing bad credit. Did you know a 40-point increase in your credit score can save you $40,000 on a home loan and $4,000 on a car loan? You deserve good credit and peace of mind. Take the first step today and go to bluewatercredit.com and register for a free consultation from one of their credit repair experts. That's bluewatercredit.com.
Trimming of your retirement does not include losing your house. However, due to today's lower stock market, higher medical bills, and taxes, many retirees face this very problem. This is why it is necessary that you, as a baby boomer considering retirement within the next 10 years, understand reverse mortgages and what one could do for you or your parents. A reverse mortgage could make it possible for you or your parents to travel, buy a second home, or start a new business. For more information about reverse mortgages, just call our off-air number at 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit realestateradiowithron.com and click the free workshop button.
Are you currently renting a home? Do you like paying someone else's mortgage payment? Why not explore the options to purchase your own home? Can you imagine a 30-year fixed rate below 3.5% APR? This means with $10,500, you can purchase a $300,000 home and have a principal and interest payment of about $1,300 per month. What are you paying in rent? Does your family deserve the opportunity to take advantage of the current market? To learn more about these exciting opportunities, the Siegel Lending Team is standing by to speak with you. Call now, 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L, LendingTeam.com. Rates subject to change without notice. License to NMLS ID 217037, Equal Housing Lender. Not endorsed or sponsored by any government agency.
Are you paying rent because you cannot afford to live in your dream home? Are you paying rent because you don't believe you have the down payment funds to purchase your own home? At Siegel Lending Team at runismylender.com has up to $25,000 to help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. Contact the Siegel Lending Team today at runismylender.com. Again, runismylender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037. runismylender.com.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
To be living here today, as the flag still stands.
Radio, within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That is my message, and I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio anytime at 800-306-1990. 800-306-1990. So I'm going to give you something that's a little bit different today. We'll do things a little bit out of order. We're going to talk about a home loan strategy. How about purchasing a new home? And I'm going to talk to you about this because then I'm going to chat with our guest about this function. He doesn't even know where I'm going with this. Of course, most people don't know where I'm heading. I do things a little bit odd many, many times. But I want to share this with you because I've told you many, many times, strategy beats rate every single time. So I've got this strategy that I'm showing you. If you're watching us on ronsiegelradio.tv, if you're watching us on the AM 1490 our ABC News and Talk video feed, you're going to see this strategy on any of our socials as well. We're going to have a purchase price of a home, $650,000. And I told you that yesterday we shared this information on all of our social channels. Median home price, Orange County, $808,000. Median price, Riverside County, about $435,000, give or take. So I used a number right in the middle here. Purchase price, $650,000. Loan amount, $500,000. Now, if you were to go do a straight loan at $500,000, again, this is just educational purposes. Your numbers are going to be slightly different. But a $500,000 loan, and you're going to have some purchasing and closing costs in there. Interest rate right now, about 2.875, maybe 2.91 on the APR. 30-year fixed rate payment, $2,913. Now, think about this concept. If you've got a great real estate agent, and I'm sitting next to one, you've got a great real estate agent that understands the concept of a seller buy-down. Now, a lot of times people say, I got a $650,000 purchase. I'm going to offer $625,000, but I'm going to say to you why. How about offering $650,000 and ask the seller to contribute 2% to buying down your interest rate? Do you know what your interest rate's going to be? 2.375, 2.56 is the APR. So you've got a lower APR even. And now you're talking about a $2,781 purchase or payment every month. Pretty good savings, right? Now, think about what that means to you. That's $131 a month in savings. Now, I'm showing you that right there on the screen if you're watching us again, ronsiegelradio.tv or the AM 1490 KBC news feed, video feed. Now, over the course of a short period of time, 5 years, that's going to save you $12,000 in interest. Think about that, $12,000. Over the course of 10 years, you're going to save $23,000 in interest by doing this. $23,000 by asking the seller if they will help you out instead of you asking and negotiating a price concession. How about a seller concession to help buy down that interest rate? Now, those of you that have a problem qualifying, yeah, you're going to qualify easier if you've got to have a $2,700, $2,800 payment versus a $2,900 payment, right? Doesn't sound like a lot, but when you start adding these things up, I would say, and I don't know about you, I'm just a little radio guy here, maybe not a little radio guy, doing a little radio. I'm a guy doing a little radio, right? $23,000 savings over 10 years, $23,000. To me, $23,000 is a lot of money. Maybe not to you. I know there's some people that are making boatloads of money out there. But I like the idea of understanding strategy. If you're going to be in that house for 10 years or more, I'm going to share with you that that makes sense to me to save that money. Don't give it to the bank. That is just a little bit of a home loan strategy brought to you by MySoCalLender.com. MySoCalLender.com. So we're going to chat this morning. Our friend Lucas Smith is with us. Sometimes I get the name of his company right. Sometimes I don't because it's a long one. Do I have it right? The Smith team at Your Home Sold Guaranteed?
Your Home Sold Guaranteed Realty, Ron. Our name is our promise. It's really simple. We guarantee the sale of your home or we buy it.
You know something, and I'm a simple guy, so I like simple.
It's easy, right?
I've been told I'm easy, so every once in a while.
So that's not what Mindy told me.
There we go. Okay. We might have to put his mic back on mute, guys.
So how's the real estate market out there? That's fantastic, man. The real estate market is fantastic right now, Ron.
So is that if you're a buyer, if you're a seller, if you're a renter?
Well, if you're a renter, it always sucks. Renting sucks. I talk to renters all day, every day. They call me on my advertising and marketing, and they say, I want to buy a home. And my first question is, why? And they say, because renting sucks. Paying somebody else's mortgage and building equity for somebody else sucks.
Yeah, and you know something? I can completely concur with you. It's not fun paying somebody else's mortgage. Now, there's some strategic times that you must. I get it. But what we want to really talk about is the fact of how you can get into that first home. And I just shared a strategy here, and I'm sure that you're familiar with doing things like that and having people, you know, it's all about negotiations, right? And that's one of the things I talk about, having a great team behind you when you're looking to buy a house. Because some people think, yeah, it's an easy market right now.
Well, and that's really the critical thing, is who you choose to represent you. Right. I'm not saying you have to choose us or our team, although you should, but if who you choose to represent you. The problem that we have today is in the information age, with all of the property information readily available, people think, what do I need a real estate agent for? And it's exactly that. It's does your real estate agent know enough to speak fluidly about strategy and different things you can do to set yourself apart from other buyers and other sellers in this marketplace? To make sure that you get your heart's desire, what you really want.
So I'm a big proponent. I've said right along that I really don't need a real estate agent to find property for me, to go on the internet and find a piece of property. I can do that on my own, right?
Of course.
I can't. Now, for those of you that don't believe this is true, I will share with you that every good agent, just somehow they'll take those properties when they get a new listing. And they look at their book and who's out shopping before it ever hits the ML. I know it's not supposed to happen that way, but they're making phone calls to their clientele because that's what their job is, to take care of their people, right? So they're, if just because you look and see on the internet, well, I didn't see 123 Main Street, never hit the internet. Well, yeah, that's because it went pending about an hour after it was listed. That happens. But for the most part, you're going to find the properties on the internet. You can see the pictures on the internet. You don't need an agent to show you pictures, to pick up their phone and say, here, Mrs. Smith, here's the pictures of this property. You don't need that. What you need, I'm going to question you on this one, Lucas, is I need help because, you know, I'm just a simple guy here. I need help from the time I decide on a property. I need your expertise. What's the value of it?
Absolutely. You need help and advice on what the value of it is. And again, strategy for getting you the best value for you. What fits your wants, your needs, what's important to your family? Because we're all different.
Absolutely.
Right? We all have different wants and needs for our family.
And we're at different stages of life.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, we were talking before the broadcast, and I think you said you've got 20-year-old children.
Yeah, our son is 22.
22. Mine's 30. Right. So you're probably not dealing with a baby on the way.
Oh, thank God.
Right. A marriage on the way. I've got one married, one getting married. I'm in a different place right now than you are. Right.
Right.
Everybody is.
Right.
So your home loan strategy or your home purchasing strategy is going to be different based on where you are. I'm in a different spot than a 75-year-old. Right. So my big belief is, but what I really need a real estate agent for is from the time I find the property of my dreams to getting it to be mine.
Right.
Right? There's that contract, I mean, it's made to confuse people.
Well, yes. Yes, it is. And you want somebody who's fluid, who knows the market, who's knowledgeable, who has the width and breadth of experience to advise you for where you're at in your stage of life in order to get the best deal for you.
Right. And sometimes the best deal isn't price.
No.
Right? It's the location, the school that you want, the proximity to your job, proximity to family. Right? Those are all parts of what's going to go in. You might want to overpay because something else is more important to you.
Right.
Now, the other part of it is that contract, 37 page or 17 pages, something like that?
Yes.
Somewhere along there, right?
Plus disclosures.
Plus disclosures, right? So you got to understand that whole contract. And what are the surprises in there? Right? There's no surprises to the guy that's done 10, 20, 30 transactions a year. To the guy like me that does one every 5 years. But I lead a lending team. I'm not qualified to write that contract. I've got a license that says, my license says I'm qualified, right? But I'm not qualified.
You're not my real estate agent, Ron.
Right.
Exactly. I love you. I would use you for my loans. You're great.
I wouldn't use me for real estate.
Right. But you wouldn't be my real estate agent. Right. And it's not just the contract, right? People say, well, I can read English, so I can read the contract. Of course you can. Disclosures, right? The natural hazard zone disclosure report, the title report, all of those disclosures that come along with it, right? Who do you have that's representing you that's reading those and making sure that there's nothing going on with that property that you need to be aware of so that you can go in eyes wide open and make a good purchase for your family?
Absolutely. And I heard a good one. I'm going to talk to Lucas about this when we come back, but I heard a good one just yesterday. That in La Quinta, California, last I see, there hasn't been any real major fires there, not like Yorba Linda, California, or Silverado Canyon, or so many of the other areas. But a consumer said to me yesterday that he can't get fire insurance on his house because of the way it was built. We'll talk more about that when we come back. You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. We're going to also chat just a little bit about rent versus buy, how to decide what's best for you, what's best for your family. We've got a mortgage minute coming up for you as well. All that and more. You can reach me anytime. Our off-air number, it's 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, on Twitter @ronsiegel. And if you miss any part of our broadcast, Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Ron Siegel, the number 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
I worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away.
Hi, we're here with Ron Siegel, the host of Real Estate Radio. Ron, welcome to the studio. Give us insight as to what your show is all about.
Hi, Eric. Thanks for having me. Thanks for asking me that question. The reason we developed Real Estate Radio is right now there is an abundance of misinformation out there. So Real Estate Radio is a show designed to give Southern California a focal point for their real estate knowledge, as well as a place to go just in case they might need anything real estate related.
So how are you helping people?
That's actually pretty simple. People need advice. So it really doesn't matter who you are. If you have any real estate questions, we're here to help. Whether you're buying a home, selling, you're experiencing a loan modification, short sale, foreclosure, there are a lot of things going on in this marketplace.
How can people get a hold of you?
Real easy. All you have to do is call. The number is 1-800-306-1990, press option 1.
Interesting times in the market right now. Where do you think the markets are going from here?
That's a great question. All I can say is this. The housing market came down one house at a time, and what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to build it one house, one family at a time. So the best thing that anyone can do is access the free advice that we really want to give you. And to do that, you simply need to call me. The number is 1-800-306-1990, option 1. I'd really love to help.
Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investments? Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
door.
Are you paying rent because you think you cannot afford to live in your dream home? Are you renting because you don't believe that you have the down payment funds to purchase your own home? The Siegel Lending Team at RonIsMyLender.com has up to $25,000 to help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. Contact the Siegel Lending Team today at RonIsMyLender.com. Again, RonIsMyLender.com, licensed under NMLS 217037. RonIsMyLender.com.
Are you currently renting a home? Do you like paying someone else's mortgage payment? Why not explore the options to purchase your own home? Can you imagine a 30-year fixed rate below 3.5% APR? This means with $10,500, you can purchase a $300,000 home and have a principal and interest payment of about $1,300 per month. What are you paying in rent? Does your family deserve the opportunity to take advantage of the current market? To learn more about these exciting opportunities, the Siegel Lending Team is standing by to speak with you. Call now, 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L, LendingTeam.com. Rates subject to change without notice. Licensed to NMLS ID 217037, Equal Housing Lender. Not endorsed or sponsored by any government agency.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert, Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Well, I'm really lucky. I mean, I feel so blessed all the time as I sit here talking to you in the morning. I got the greatest job in the world. I got to tell you, I get the opportunity every morning to come in here, chat with you about things, try and give some perspective, some education, bring some realty to reality to some of the things that are going on. And it could only be done in this country. I mean, I've traveled on business many, many times, many, many places. I've been to some of the communist countries. And you know something? No matter what goes on here, you know, I listened to an article or a book just recently. Sarah Huckabee Sanders' book is a great book. And her dad made a comment that isn't it nice that people are fighting to get into this country and no one really fights to get out? So I play this God Bless the USA today on Election Day. I hope you've gotten out and voted. You know, I say two things: get educated and go vote. I mean, yeah, there's many, many people that have died for us to have the right to go out and vote. Take that opportunity. Don't waste that opportunity. So I just throw my two cents in there as I do every day. That's what you tune in for. And I appreciate you. I appreciate you as tuning in. I don't take it for granted ever. So let's chat about our real-time real estate segment today, being brought to you by the area trusted real estate professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Text SLT Home Digest to 795-64. Find your dream home before someone else does. Rent versus buy, how to decide what's best for you. And if you're watching again on ronsiegelradio.tv, any of our social channels, or the AM 1490 KBC News and Talk video feed, you're going to see a chart right now that talks about median asking rent since 1988. That slope is so steep, I wouldn't even want to ski it if I knew how to ski. Right? That's not what you want to be doing. But according to the U.S. Census Bureau, median rent continues to rise. With today's low mortgage rates, there's great opportunity for current renters to make a move into homeownership that stretches each dollar a little bit further. While the best timeline to buy a home is different for everyone, the questions are not. Should I continue renting or is it time for me to buy? The answer depends on your current situation and your future plans. So here are some of the thoughts to help you decide if you're ready to own a home of your own. Number one, rent will continue to increase. This is one of the top reasons why renters decide to move, because in most cases, rent will continue increasing each year. As noted, the U.S. Census Bureau recently released its quarterly homeownership report. And as the graph shows, median rent is climbing year after year. When you own a home, you lock in your monthly payment for the life of the loan, creating consistency and predictability in your payments. Number two, freedom to customize. This is a big decision-making point for many people who want to be able to paint, renovate, and make home upgrades. In many cases, landlords determine all of these selections and prefer you do not alter them as a renter. As a homeowner, you have the freedom to decorate and personalize your home to make it truly your own. Privacy. When renting, your landlord has access to your space in case of an emergency. If you own your home, however, you're the one to decide who can come inside. Given today's health concerns around the pandemic, maybe growing priority for you. Number four, flexibility of relocation. If you're renting, it may be easier to move quickly. Should you have a job transfer, simply decide it's time for change when you're a homeowner and need to sell your house. This might take a little more time. Today, however, with the housing market's low inventory, this may no longer be the case. Homes are selling at a record-breaking pace. And remember, I shared with you a brand new listing yesterday in our featured home segment. Got a message from the agent this morning. It sold yesterday. That's just listed. Just went on the market Saturday. Featured home yesterday, sold today. Appreciate that. And I'm sure that the departing family is happy about that as well. Building equity when you pay your rent, your landlord earns the equity property gains. If you own your home, the benefits of investment go directly toward your net worth. Number six is tax advantages. I'm not a CPA. You should check with yours. A lot of tax advantages. Remember I told you earlier, last segment, about that the seller buy-down program? Well, if you pay points on a new home purchase for primary residence, that's a tax deduction. Bottom line, if it's up to you to decide if you prefer to rent or buy, it's different for every person. If you'd like to learn more about the pros and cons of each, as well as resources to help you along the way, let's chat. I've got some great information for you. We've got some very interesting analysis that we have available. All you have to do is call our team, and we'll put those analyses together for you. I only deal with the numbers, right? So I can't tell you all the other parts of it. I'm a numbers guy when it gets to the point of saying about the property. Well, you got to have a great real estate agent. We are chatting with one today. Talk to him just a minute about this, but that's the real-time real estate segment brought to you by the area trusted real estate professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Text SLT Home Digest to 79564. Find your dream home before someone else does. Lucas Smith is in the house. We're chatting real estate today. We were chatting before the break and in the break about owning your own home and all the things that go into owning your home. And the idea of the contract, or the rent versus own, can you bring in a lot of people from that rental side into home ownership, Lucas?
Quite a few, yeah. Over 50% of the buyers that we work with are renters who are ready to buy.
50%?
Over 50%, yeah. The average rent for a single-family residence here in North Orange County is at about $3,000 a month. So for most people, you know, simple math, $36,000 a year that you're giving to somebody else to live in their home.
Sure. And we talked about that in the last segment. I mean, think about it, or earlier about with that seller assistance strategy that we were talking about, right? That was talking less than $3,000 to own that $650,000 home.
Right.
Right. So those are the concepts that you have to think about going into this. And I just heard as I was coming to the studio this morning, brand new numbers from CoreLogic. 88% of millennials say they want to own their own home. Right? 4 or 5 years ago, we were talking about this same thing, and we were talking about the idea that the millennials were really into renting.
Yeah, wasn't it like 50 or less than 50% right, who wanted to own their own home, 48%, something like that?
Yeah, now we're at 88%.
That's fantastic.
Right? I mean, it's just talking to the thought that people are understanding the beauty of home ownership, right? And I know that you're bilingual. I know that you help a lot of the Spanish-speaking citizens in our communities. And the idea of owning a home in this country, that's a major, major issue.
It's the American dream, Ron.
Right.
And just to be clear, yo hablo poquito español.
Okay.
Mi esposa, mucho, mucho español. Yo, sí. Poquito.
Yeah, I
se aprendo.
So now you're getting beyond where my knowledge base.
I'm learning, Ron.
Well, you know something? When your wife speaks it, you better understand it. Otherwise, you're going to be in serious trouble.
Well, when I'm in trouble, I understand every word.
Yeah, because you're going to get. I'm not going to go there. I got a beautiful wife, so I'm sure that she takes care of you well.
Of course.
But the idea here is that people don't understand. I mean, I've watched, I think in Mexico, I don't think you're able to own real estate unless you've got a Mexican citizenship.
That's correct.
Right? So here, I mean, you don't have to be an American citizen to own real estate. You've got to be here legally, right? You've got to have the right paperwork, documentation, and we're not getting into that part of the discussion. But the idea here, a lot of people really want to get into the home ownership world.
Absolutely. And you've mentioned new homes for a couple of times here. Can we circle back to that for just brief second?
Absolutely.
So new homes, if anybody listening to this is thinking of buying a new home,
you know, it's fantastic, right? It's like buying a new car. You're going to pay a premium, but you're going to get something brand new. Even then, make sure you have your own real estate agent representing you. Don't just use the builder's agent. Those contracts are more binding than a standard real estate contract. They're all in favor of the builder, and you definitely want somebody fluent with those contracts reading it before you sign it.
So being that I am not a real estate, I'm not a member of the California Association of Realtors or the National Association of Realtors, I can tell you this because they don't want someone like Lucas to tell you this. If you go into a new development, don't sign the paperwork or put down Mickey Mouse, right? I'm serious. Put down that Mickey Mouse just checked in or Donald Duck or whatever. That way you can call your real estate professional, somebody that's going to look out for you, right? Because the builder is not looking out for you. They've had an attorney or team of attorneys that work for them, look out for them, write a contract for them. Now, the California Association of Realtors contract, that really, in my opinion, protects the buyer probably more than the seller.
It does. It does lean a little bit towards the buyer, but the builder contracts will lean entirely towards the builder.
Entirely.
So when you want to go see those homes, take your agent with you.
Absolutely.
Please.
Yeah, and that's not because I'm just a honk for realtors, because I'll tell you right now, 9 times out of 10, I tell consumers if they're going to buy a home from a realtor, use the realtor's lender, right? Because he's going to give you a better deal because they've built some money in to make that happen. But it's not going to change the pricing when you're using your own real estate professional, and you can get the royal shaft if you don't do that, if you don't have somebody looking out for you. So that's a great point.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's really imperative. And again, like you said, it's not about pushing for realtors or lenders. I'm a consumer advocate.
Right.
My job is to, just like yours, my job is to serve people, Ron, right? And make sure people get served in the fashion that they deserve.
Right. And the idea there is, and you know something, I say it this all the time. I do that because that's what I do. Consumer advocate, I'm here for you every single morning trying to educate you. I still have to take care of my family just like you do. Thank goodness we're taken care of very, very well through friends, family, coworkers, people we're able to help through the radio program. But our focus here is I know that if I give you great information, whether you use the lending team or not, you're not going to get the shaft, and you're going to have a better experience. And, you know, some of you might think about us, you know, down the road at some point in time. So that's just some basic information right there that I share with you. We're going to talk more with Lucas Smith when we come back. I might even drop the mortgage minute so that we can give you more information and I can have more time to chat with Lucas. You're listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. You can reach me anytime. Our off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, on Twitter @ronsiegel. And if you miss any part of our broadcast, once again, shame on you. But the replay is available. Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Ron Siegel number 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
And I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today. 'Cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget.
Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams, or simply where you think you can afford? Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investments? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey, and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Do you have a goal of mortgage-free home ownership? What if your home was valued at $500,000? Are you aware that a free and clear home could be costing you $2,500 every month, $30,000 per year? The mortgage planners at the Siegel Lending Team would like to show you how you can own your home, generate tax-free income, and accumulate family wealth. You simply need to call Ron Siegel at 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. By sending the team a copy of your most recent mortgage statement, the team will send you a no-obligation mortgage adoption plan. You be the judge if it's right for your family. Again, all you have to do is send the team a copy of your mortgage statement by email to map@ronsiegelradio.com or call today Ron Siegel, 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Rate subject to change without notice, licensed by the California Department of Corporation and MLS 217037 and DKLBRE number 01869452.
Are you paying rent because you cannot afford to live in your dream home? Are you paying rent because you don't believe you have the down payment funds to purchase your own home? At Siegel Lending Team at runismylender.com has up to $25,000 to help qualified people purchase their own home at amazing interest rates. Contact the Siegel Lending Team today at runismylender.com. Again, runismylender.com. Licensed under NMLS 217037. runismylender.com.
Do you believe Southern California real estate is a...
To be living here today, cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where it...
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That is my message, and I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The Mortgage Minute today being brought to you by MySoCalLender.com, MySoCalLender.com. Got all the programs and the products. You just need to make the call, 800-306-1990, as I share with you every day. Usually I do the Mortgage Minute a little bit earlier in the broadcast, but today I'll tell you that the Dow Jones is now up 569 points. NASDAQ, it's up 229 points. Nice. The S&P 500 is up 6880. 10-year Treasury, that's up 4 basis points on the yield. The mortgage-backed securities are down 2 basis points, which means interest is just ever so slightly up, not enough to even talk about. Probably go up once we see who's elected. That's a whole different story. But we're watching all of that for you. CoreLogic released their home price index report for September. And once again, they missed the mark. It's hard to believe, but they did it again.
Ow!
Yeah, so the home price index showed that home prices increased 1.1% during the month, 6.7% on a year-over-year basis. Big improvement from the 5.9 year-over-year number reported last month. Remember that the forecast, CoreLogic, came up and said that 0.2% was going to be their total for the year after earlier in the year saying that real estate would be down 6.6%. Down 6.6%.
You don't know better than that.
Yeah, absolutely. You definitely know better than that if you're a listener of Ron Siegel Radio. Within the report, the hottest markets were Phoenix, up 11.1%. San Diego, up 7.1%. Los Angeles, up 6.3%. So just be aware of some of those numbers. We've got a lot of information coming out. The rest of this week is going to be busy in the financial markets. Tomorrow we get the ADP employment report calling for 600,000 new jobs. Friday we get the BLS jobs report. They're also looking for 600,000 new jobs. Unemployment rate is estimated to drop from 7.9 to 7.7. And the Fed will also begin its two-day meeting on Wednesday. And on Thursday we're going to get their statement at their press conference. And obviously today, the big news of the day, yeah, we've got the election. And I, you know, we just make sure you go out and vote. Get educated, go vote. I've got my I voted sticker on. I didn't put my hat on because my headphones get in the way, but I do have a hat that says, stand up for your country. Yeah, that doesn't go with the people like LeBron James, who goes out there and gives bad information to people and promotes the idea. I wonder what other country he could go to that he might be able to be happier at. I want to see the man be happy, and maybe he's not happy here. Maybe he'll leave. But that's just my opinion. So chatting this morning, Lucas Smith is in the house. He's a realtor extraordinaire here in North Orange County, predominantly. So your comments. I don't want to get political, but the idea of, you know, look at your shirt, Dave. Don't get political. Right, but I'm sure you're.
I'm not telling anybody who I voted for, Ron. I'm just keeping that a secret.
Yeah,
there's so much dissent out there. I don't want to let anybody know.
Yeah, the whole concept here is that we just want to make sure people go out and vote. Right, real estate. It's going to be, you know, and you and I chatted about this. Regardless of what side of the aisle you're on, right? Tomorrow we're going to get up, and we're going to still live in the greatest country on earth. There's still going to be people that are going to be out there going and saying, you know something, I think it's wise for my family to own a house in California or some other part of the country.
Oh, absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely. Yeah, that's, life's going to go on. You know, people are going to keep doing what people do, right?
Right.
And things are going to keep going well, right, for the intern.
Yeah, right? that's the whole idea. So real estate, what do you forecast? I mean, I just gave you the numbers that CoreLogic came up with. And there wasn't a whole lot of logic in their numbers earlier in the year. Yeah, they're still saying that there's still a little light on it. What are you seeing in the marketplace here in the areas you serve?
So let me preface this by saying that I've made market predictions before and been astronomically wrong.
Okay.
Okay, so just don't anybody go to Vegas and place a large bet on this. but what we're seeing right now is we're seeing prices consistently rise.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Okay.
We're seeing a lot of, and the reason prices are rising is a simple supply and demand, right? There's not a lot of supply. There's not a lot of listings coming onto the market, and there's a lot of buyer demand. So with that demand, that's causing price increasing. What I think we're going to see after the first of the year is I think we're going to see more inventory coming onto the market. I think we're going to see the demand still stay consistent, but we're going to see pricing level out because of that. I don't think we're going to see a crash or a downfall. I think we're going to see a leveling of pricing and a more balancing in the market.
Yeah, I think you're spot on there because there's so many areas there. There's a lot of people that are saying, you know, suddenly they've gone through this unfortunate pandemic and they had trouble making payments. They know that they've got the solution. If they've got a Fannie Mae or Freddie Mac product or FHA, VA, USDA, they've got there's solutions for that. But there's some people that are going to say, you know, something, I've got some equity. And I think my solution is not going to be to put those payments on the end, which you have the right to do. You know, you just have to talk to your servicer. But I'm going to say, you know, something, I'm just going to take my equity and run for right now.
Yeah, I think so. And I think I hear a lot of people talking about, well, there's going to be a crash. There's going to be a huge amount of foreclosures. I don't think we're going to see that. I think we're going to see a lot of the forbearance stack it onto the end if they're going to keep the house. I think there's going to be some mandates in that.
Sure.
You know, put out by the federal government who heavily regulates our lending industry and our housing market.
Absolutely. Yeah.
and I don't think we're going to see a huge glut of foreclosures hit the market. I don't see that happening.
And that's good news because, I mean, we all went through that in 2008, 2009. Millennials that are listening to us, please know that all recessions are not like 2008, 2009. In fact, the majority of the recessions, real estate increases in value. A lot of people don't tell you that, but real estate increases in many, many recessions. So, and we're coming out of this recession right now. I mean, who knows what's going to happen depending upon the election, right? But, and no one really can forecast where that's going. I mean, everyone has their own opinions, right? But if we continue on the current path, we already saw 31% growth in GDP. We're still back a little bit, right?
Huge record job numbers. Yeah. Right. Record low unemployment. And when people work, right, people spend money. This is a basic tenet of economies.
We don't save in this country. That's just the way, right? I mean, that's the way it is.
Yeah,
I mean,
that's the way it is.
I'm not saying that that's good or bad, but, you know, there is another thing that we don't always talk about this in real estate. Real estate is actually a form of forced savings, right? Because every payment that you make has a component of it that's going to principal that's your money.
Right, yeah. Yeah, you're paying down your mortgage, you're paying down your note, you're accruing equity that way, and as your real estate increases in value, you're also accruing equity in that way. So you're accruing equity on a spread basis.
Sure, so you're getting more equity from the payment you're making, and you're making more equity from the appreciation. And, you know, we're here in Southern California. You know, I have some friends that are in the Ohio area, and they talk, well, they can buy a house and sell a house 20 years later, and the value hasn't really changed. That's not the case here in Southern California.
No, we would call that a mobile home here in California.
That's good. I like that line. Yeah, I mean, the bottom line is that we really do see that our values are constantly going up, and it's a great investment. So if you're a young person right now listening to us, now do whatever you can. Beg, borrow, don't steal, but get into that first piece of property, right? I mean, I do this every year at this time. Talk to mom, dad, grandma, grandpa. There's down payment assistance programs, up to $25,000 in down payment assistance. So you don't even have to ever rent a home. Think about that concept.
Well, and that down payment is the biggest hurdle for most people that we talk to. And that's the message that we preach to people, right? We're in the service industry. Our job is to serve and educate people. So we say there's solutions for that. There's down payment assistance. There's great programs if you're a veteran of our armed services. There's USDA programs out there if the property qualifies for those. There's a lot of different solutions to get you into that home so that you're making that same payment you pay for your rent, but you're owning.
Well, that's great information, right? I mean, that's exactly what we want to be doing is get out, make a call, right? I mean, there's no way, I wouldn't have a clue if somebody asked me to do something in plumbing and electrical in a lot of different areas of this world. But if you're thinking about buying a house, if you've got a desire at all, if you're one of that 88% of millennials that want to buy a house, give us a call, 800-306-1990. I don't know whether you qualify, but I can tell you one thing for sure, other than fraud, I don't turn people down when it comes to lending. We might set a game plan. Lucas and I have spoken about that before. We might set a game plan for you. It might be that today's not the right day, but there is a day that is yours. And as always, I ask you, set that first radio preset button to come back here and join Ron Siegel Radio, where we only speak about items affecting your house and your bank account. Thanks to all of our sponsors. A big thanks to you for spending a little bit of your day with us. We appreciate Lucas Smith for coming in and joining us. If you want to meet any of our guests, want me to introduce you to Lucas, give me a call, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or RonSiegelRadio.com. And remember, make a lot of money so you can help a lot of people and have a lot of fun. Have a great day. We'll talk to you next time on Ron Siegel Radio.
Thank my lucky stars to be living here today, because the flag still stands for freedom. And